If I'm gonna keep up with my friends, I'm gonna need the perfect deck. And that is definitely not it. No, no, no. Maybe there's something in here I can work with. No, 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 no. All right, now this I can work with. When it comes to building a successful deck, attacking is usually the most important part. After all, attacking is how you take knockouts, and taking knockouts awards you prize cards, which is how you win the game. When you want to start building a deck, it helps to take a look at your main attacker, and then decide which support Pokemon and trainers synergize with it best. In today's episode, I'm going to show you how to build a deck that supports a specific attack using concepts we've covered throughout the season. Charizard, I choose you. Leon is one of the most amazing trainers from the Galar region. His bond with his Charizard is so strong that he's never lost a battle. Their incredible connection is replicated in the Pokemon TCG with the supporter card Leon and Charizard from Vivid Voltage. Charizard has the Royal Blaze attack, which does 100 damage plus 50 more damage for each Leon in your discard pile. Leon is a supporter, which makes your Pokemon's attacks do 30 more damage during your turn. With 4 Leon in the discard pile and a Leon played as your supporter for the turn, it's possible to do 330 damage with Charizard for just 2 fire energy. But swinging for 330 damage isn't exactly easy. This attack is going to require some support. Fortunately, Charizard has some support built in with its Battle Sense ability. Battle Sense allows you to look at the top 3 cards of your deck and put a card you find there into your hand before discarding the remaining cards. Battle Sense is an excellent way to burn through the deck and find Leon or other key resources, but as a Stage 2 Pokemon, sometimes Charizard needs a little help to get set up. I think Chinchino's Make Do ability, which allows you to discard a card from your hand and draw 2 cards, is the perfect support option for Charizard. Not only does it allow you to simultaneously discard cards like Leon and draw cards, but this much draw lets you play Leon over other supporters during your turn to boost damage too. As we've learned so far this season, drawing cards is only one piece of the deck building puzzle. Another key component to building a successful deck is accelerating energy. Charizard's Royal Blaze attack only costs 2 fire energy, so it doesn't really need much in the way of energy acceleration, but you will need something to help you attack turn after turn. Raihan is a supporter card that can only be played if one of your Pokemon was knocked out during your opponent's last turn, and it's an awesome choice to pair with Charizard. It allows you to attach a basic energy from your discard pile to one of your Pokemon, then search your deck for any card you want and put it into your hand. Since Charizard and Chinchino only give up a single prize card when they get knocked out, it means that there will be multiple times in a game where Raihan can be used to accelerate energy. Whoa, we have covered a lot of ground here. Let's try a pop quiz to test your memory. How much damage does Leon boost your attacks by? 10 damage, 20 damage, or 30 damage? That's right, Leon boosts your Pokemon's attacks by 30 damage during your turn. That's why he's the best trainer in all of Galar. Usually, you want your attackers to take as little damage as possible in battle. But sometimes Pokemon get more powerful when they have damage counters on them. Single Strike Urshifu from Chilling Rain is a great example of this. Urshifu is a Stage 1 Pokemon with 140 hit points and 2 attacks. The attack we're taking a look at is Fists of Strife, which does 100 damage plus 100 more damage if Urshifu has any damage counters on it, all for 2 darkness and a colorless energy. That's pretty wild, right? If only there was a way to accelerate energy onto Urshifu and place damage counters on it at the same time. You know what they say, Houndoom are a single strike Pokemon's best friend. Houndoom's Single Strike Roar ability accelerates a Single Strike energy from your deck to one of your Single Strike Pokemon in play, then places two damage counters on them. Single Strike energy can be attached to Single Strike Pokemon and provides either a Dark or a Fighting energy while boosting your damage by 20. With multiple Houndoom in play, you'll be able to accelerate enough energy to attack with Fists of Strife over and over again. Urshifu and Houndoom have amazing synergy. One of the key differences between the Urshifu deck and the Charizard deck is draw support. Where Charizard and Chinchino are both draw support Pokemon, Houndoom is an energy accelerator, and Urshifu has no abilities at all. This means that the Urshifu deck will need help with draw support from other sources. Bruno is a single strike supporter that complements Urshifu really well. Bruno allows you to shuffle your hand into your deck and draw 4 cards, but if one of your Pokemon was knocked out during your opponent's last turn, you get to draw 7 cards instead. Since Houndoom's Single Strike Roar ability damages your own attackers, odds are that they're going to be getting knocked out pretty frequently, making Bruno an elite choice for the Urshifu deck. Another great draw support option for single strike decks is Tower of Darkness. Tower of Darkness is a stadium card that allows you to discard a single strike card from your hand and draw 2 cards. Since your bench will usually feature a couple of attackers and a few Houndoom, space in a single strike deck is fairly limited. Tower of Darkness gives you a way to draw more cards without eating up valuable bench space or utilizing your supporter for the turn. Building decks is an adventure. There are so many strategies to discover in the Pokemon TCG, and there's nothing more rewarding than building your own deck and watching the cards come together just right. Charizard and Urshifu are just 2 powerful attackers that you can build a deck around, but there are so many more. Read the attacks and abilities of cards in your collection and keep your eyes peeled for cards that synergize well with your hero Pokemon. Let me know in the comments below which Pokemon you're most excited to craft a deck for, and make sure to stay tuned for the next episode of Top Deck Academy.